30-minute time limit. From the state of Pennsylvania, weighing in at 568 pounds, Brian Knobb and Jerry Sags, the Nasty Boys. At a combined weight of 450 pounds, Robert Gibson and Ricky Morton. Ladies and gentlemen, the Rock and Roll Express. Gary DeRusha is the referee. At ringside, Rod Trogdon and Lee Marshall.
Here they come.
Whoa, look out.
Four-time tag team champions of the world going for five. The Rock and Roll Express. But let me tell you something, ladies and gentlemen, and Lee Marvin already. Lee Marvin, hello there. Marshall already knows this. That in the Nasty Boys, you talk about nasty.
Yep.
These two guys grew up together. You know, it's almost scary to try to strike up a conversation with them, because you just never know what they're going to do next. But they did tell me that they grew up together in Whitehall, Pennsylvania. They went to high school together. They were in alley fights together.
That I believe.
They have been together for 16 years. And they know how to be nasty.
Well, you know, Rod, I've taken some criticism because I've gone on record, and I will not withdraw this statement. I like the Nasty Boys, and I'm going to tell you why. This is professional wrestling. This is the toughest sport in the world, and I admire anybody that can come into an arena, put on their boots and tights, and get ready to fight. And the Nasty Boys come here to fight every time. You don't have to like them. You don't have to go out and have dinner with them. And certainly you don't have to let your daughter date them. But you have to respect anybody that's going to come in here with this kind of tenacity and look to make a name for themselves in the AWA, the Major League of Professional Wrestling.
They certainly wouldn't date my daughter. They wouldn't get close to her. Absolutely no way. As Jerry Sags is working over Bob Gibson, Robert Gibson.
What a move by Robert Gibson.
Oh,
man, in comes Ricky Morton.
And Gibson delivers a blow to the solar plexus. And now Morton with a head scissors on Sags.
Oh.
And a little help from Gibson, and down they go. And out they go.
You talk about a house cleaning, the Rock and Roll Express chasing both Sags and Knobs right out of the ring. But I got a guarantee for you, they're going to come firing right back. These guys are tough.
There is a song by the late Jim Croce. You don't mess around with Jim.
Yeah.
Well, hey, you don't mess around with the Rock and Roll Express either.
You're absolutely wrong, right? Right, Rod. The Rock and Roll Express came here for the same purpose as the Nasty Boys, the same purpose as the Midnight Rockers, and the same purpose as Bad Company. They all want those scraps of gold, signifying the world tag team champions, currently held by Bad Company, Pat Tanaka and Paul Diamond.
Oh, they tag so quickly.
Whoa.
So very quickly. They are totally aware of what the other is doing at all times. And probably about four or five moves ahead. And they are, to a certain extent, I believe, exasperating the Nasty Boys at this point in time, surprising them with their tenacity, with their toughness, with their quickness. The Nasty Boys have to go the, not have to, but the Nasty Boys go the rough and tumble, rock'em, sock'em route. And indeed, the Rock and Roll Express can go that same route, but they add a lot more to their arsenal as well.
And now Sags just calling Robert Gibson out to the middle of the ring. He wants a finger lace with him, a test of strength. Looks like he might get it. Yeah.
Oh, yes. And here, of course, the Nasty Boys, I believe, have it all over. The likes of Gibson and Morton in this showdown.
Well, look at Robert Gibson fighting back.
I could be wrong. He's got it turned around, or does he? No, I guess Sags is still in control so far as this knuckle lock is concerned. Here comes, uh-oh. They were both coming in. However, Brian Knobbs came first, and then referee Gary DeRusha took care of him. And while that was happening, Ricky Morton came in and drilled Jerry Sags in the solar plexus.
And once again, Sags calling him out. Saying, come on, big man. Come on, you want some of me? And apparently Ricky Morton wants some of him. Here he comes, Morton and Sags.
Oh, this is a war. This is a war. No two ways about it.
You know, Ron, I haven't talked to Stan Blackburn about this, but I've got to think that whoever wins this match would likely get the next opportunity to face Bad Company for those world titles.
Well, I, in a way, agree with you, and in a way, disagree. I would certainly think that whoever gets the next shot at the tag team champions have to go through the Midnight Rockers, first of all.
Yep,
and here is another. Oh, they go so fast, you can't even begin to describe it as it happens. Look at this. Double dynamite.
Double suplex, and down goes Brian Knobbs. Once again, standing alone in the middle of the ring, the Rock and Roll Express.
They are nothing short of sensational. And what a tag team championship, or what a tag team match it would be. I mean, this is here and now, as you see Brian Knobbs and Jerry Sags, the Nasty Boys. They want a piece of the hide of whoever the tag team champions are. But you can just see down the road the great, great matches that are yet to come here in the AWA with Bad Company, the Midnight Rockers, the Rock and Roll Express, the Nasty Boys, Baron Von Raschke and Ray the Crippler Stevens, and you go on and on and on.
Oh! Big bear hug by Ryan.
But he can't hold on to it. And the reason that he can't hold on to it is that Robert Gibson plainly and simply out-muscled him, out-fought him with a shot in the nose. And that'll sting you.
So far, Rob, so far, we've got to stick up for a young man who's taken a lot of heat over the past couple of weeks, and that's Gary DeRusha, who's doing a superb job refereeing this match. I do not envy him the job of refereeing a match between the Nasty Boys and the Rock and Roll Express. He's done a great job so far.
I know I was, not necessarily, I don't believe on duelist, but I certainly was critical of the way he handled the championship match between Bad Company and the Midnight Rockers. He's doing it all. He's doing it all right here so far in this one. As I can see and you can see and the world can see from coast to coast and continent to continent, it's the AWA from the Showboat Sports Pavilion in Las Vegas, Nevada. It's the Nasty Boys against the Rock and Roll Express. And Brian Knobbs just plainly and simply will not let go of the headlock he has on Robert Gibson, but I think he's grabbing some hair along the process to help him out.
I think you're right, Ron. Also, by this time, Robert Gibson might be a little bit lightheaded. He's had that headlock applied by Brian Knobbs for quite some time, cutting off the supply of blood. But
look at that.
Gibson reversing it into an overarm, over into a wrist.
Pull of the hair. A pull of the hair there by Brian Knobbs got him back into that side headlock. But watch these two. Watch them all. Gibson and Morton. Sags and Knobbs.
Back into the wrist lock. Tag made. Here comes Ricky Morton.
You saw Knobbs had the advantage there. However, it was, I have to believe, Gibson just allowing him to muscle him into the corner where Morton was waiting. And Morton takes over. And does he ever. There's Swift.
Oh!
Here comes Morton again.
Oh, right into the ring post, Rod.
Knobbs got out of the way, and you see the expression on the face of Ricky Morton, whose shoulder went crashing into the post And now, Sags picking him up. What has he got planned for him?
Oh, super
breaker. That shoulder again. He could bust a collarbone, dislocate a shoulder, end a career.
This crowd is absolutely electric, Rod Drongard. They are going crazy over the match between the Rock and Roll Express and the Nasty Boys.
And here is now, drilling Ricky Morton as he was pinned, the arms pinned by Sag.
Another pull to hair, and down goes Ricky Morton. Right on top of him by an arm. Oh! They're working on the arm that Morton rammed right into the ring post.
This is why they call it the most grueling sport in the world. You're seeing it happen right in front of you.
Oh, reverse atomic drop.
All the way from Miami to Montreal and from Dublin to Denver. I'm Rod Trongan along with Lee Marshall and the call of the action here on the Total Sports Network, ESPN, of this great tag team battle. And Jerry Sags clotheslines Ricky Morton. It's the Nasty Boys against the Rock and Roll Express.
And there they go again, Rod, working on that arm that Morton rammed into the ring post. I am quite surprised that that shoulder wasn't dislocated at first.
What a precarious situation Ricky Morton finds himself in here and now. And Sags not about to let up on that left arm and left shoulder. Here comes Buddy. Takes a pop with the right hand. And Knobs comes back in.
10 minutes gone in this match now, Rod.
I didn't see if there was a tag or not, but apparently there was. Now Sags again working over the shoulder of Morton as Gibson starts in but is chased by referee Gary DeRusha. And suddenly Gibson, or rather Morton, fires away and stops Knob momentarily, but Knob gets him again and tags in Jerry Sags.
This is
brutal.
He just can't seem to get out of the Nasty Boys corner line. Body slam.
Cover two.
Oh, almost a three count. Ricky Morton just able to kick out of that one. Back comes Jerry Sags. And he lays one on Robert Gibson.
And Gibson doesn't like it at
all. No way.
And in he comes. But he will have to be chased now against the Nasty Boys for cover Ricky Morton. Until such time as Gibson leads the ring. Sags comes over to Gibson, and again, Gibson has to be chased.
They did a very good job of distracting Gary DeRusha, pointing out that Ricky Morton was in, or Robert Gibson was in the ring, and they made DeRusha pay attention to it.
Oh, indeed, they learned quite quickly. There must be peace.
I think he crashed his head right under the ring. I think Jerry Sags went head first.
Look at
he's caught wide open.
Oh, is he ever?
Oh,
is he ever? Making sure he doesn't. Now Gibson working on Ryan Knobs. And here is Morton on Sags. Sags went crashing in that post. Oh, indeed. A hard shoulder block by Sags. And down goes Morton.
And you can see Morton just holding that injured shoulder, Rod.
And you see the bloodied face of Jerry Sags. And now the Nasty Boys.
They're looking for a train wreck.
Uh-oh.
Reversal.
Oh! Holy moly! This is, well, if it isn't out of control, I don't know what is, but they're letting it go. Go ahead.
I don't think DeRusha's got any choice but to let it go now, Ryan.
Indeed.
He can't get it to stop it.
Bingo from the center of the ring.
All right, they're
outside of the ring. Knobs and Ricky Morton. Gibson and Sags across the way. It is Morton pounding the head of Brian Knobs on that apron.
I don't know if Ricky Morton's bleeding as well. Oh, into the ring post goes Jerry Sags. DeRusha's finally had it up.
And now they are ringing the bell. They are ringing the bell because the count went to 10 outside of the ring, totally out of control. Jerry DeRusha making his decision. Double count out is what Jerry DeRusha says, but they're still at it.
that they're going to duke it out some more.
A whip by Knob, the whip by Sags. Oh, it goes.
Come on, that kid.
Pressing down go the Nasty Boys. And out go the Nasty Boys. And this has been World War III.
Jerry Sags is an absolute mess, Rod. When he went for the corner, Gibson moved, and Knobs went right into the ring post head first.
He's going to need not only stitches, but he's going to need dental work before this night is over. Huff. And in the ring, the Rock and Roll Express, and the crowd loves them. Rod Trongard for Lee Marshall at the Showboat Sports Pavilion in